side with my wife. And that was when we started actually learning about the business, learning about the products and how to be. Currently, yes, we're doing great. We've started building our own team, and that's why you see the Indomitables. So we actually had an initial name, an alliance, Axe Alliance. And after the anniversary we had in June, I sat with the team during one of our teaming sessions, and we all decided to go with the Indomitables. Okay, and so that became our team. But we gradually building a team with the help of Mr. Philip, and currently I'm an SE, a silver executive, and in the next month or so, we are just close to becoming gold executives. And it's been a wonderful experience in this business. We've been able to change a lot of people's lives. People who have very bad health conditions have all turned around, and that is what is motivating them to connect with us in this business and become members as well. And gradually, we are building a team. I know the COVID-19 has challenges to everyone. Mr. Jonathan shared his experience. We are learning to adapt. And so we've also been having Zoom meetings here and there, using Facebook Live as well to help build the team and impact the business knowledge to them. And we hope to make a big difference and meet with all of you pretty soon in this connected system we have. Okay. So, Annie, that's my story. It's a wonderful experience we've had joining AIM Global. And we keep inviting people, and we hope to build a bigger team and probably expand outside Ghana as well, as we're now doing. I currently have prospects in South Africa and Liberia that we are helping to also join in and build. So yes, it's not bad.
Wow. First of all, I would like to, hold on. I would like to say happy anniversary. Happy 1 year anniversary.
Thank you.
First year anniversary. So congratulations for your achievement, and I see you at the top, and hopefully I can see you also here in Philippines soon, because last year I also met mentor Philip here in Philippines. So I think he's ready now. So, you know, this person, he's a very humble, like, even if he's already successful in this business, but still, and yeah. I know he's kind of busy person, but we are just so privileged to have you here and to share his experience with the business and how he did the business successfully. So let's welcome mentor Philip Primpong from Ghana.
Thank you very much, Annie. Please forgive me. To apologize to this, you know. From where I am and then to the office is about 2 hours to get to the office and then back. All right. The traffic was too much. So please forgive me. I just got home and decided to switch. Probably my... I'm dark, you know. I don't know if everybody can see me. Yeah, internet
we can
is
see you.
Very poor.
We can see you.
You can see me. Very good. Can you see me or you can't? Can you see me?
We can see you.
I see you.
Very well.
Yeah,
very
you
well.
Are there.
That is fine. Sure. So just as I said, I want to apologize for being late. I just got home from the office. We had our brainstorming with my team members, and a lot is happening. Yeah. First of all, I thank God for giving me this privilege also, and seeing this opportunity. Yeah. I got involved in network marketing in general 10 years ago. I'm a trained laboratory technician. And I was introduced to the system, or should I say the industry, by a very good friend I was looking up. So he got me involved, and I decided to do my own research about what network marketing is all about. So I did that, and I saw it was a viable business. So I was also looking for a system, something that I can use to help other people as well. So I saw, yes, this is what I am looking for. So I got involved in a different company altogether. That was my first company I joined, and with hard work, I had the opportunity to travel to other African countries, about 3 or 4 African countries. I was a trainer there, and I achieved a lot in that company. It was rather unfortunate. The things what we were looking out for didn't happen in that company. So we needed to look for a better option. And that is when AIM Global came in some few years ago. I joined through the help of one strong lady, which we all know, Mama Ram, the top one, and who invited me to her office to introduce to me AIM Global and what is happening, and then why I should be part of AIM Global. I saw the system of AIM Global, the marketing plan, their business and everything. I saw, yes, this is what I am looking for. This is what I'm. So quickly, I got plugged into the system, and then started introducing friends and family. Just as we know, our business is all about friends and family business. So I introduced friends and family into the business. Some turned me down, as we all know, rejection here and there. But that didn't stop me because I knew what I was looking for. So I went on and on, prospecting here and there, connecting to friends and family members. And lo and behold, one day I had a call from our country manager, Mr. Mark Alion, who told me, Philip, I need your passport. In fact, I didn't know I was coming to travel because my passport has expired, and I didn't mind, you know, renewing it because I had no plans of traveling. So he was asking me during our anniversary, Philip, I need it. I need it this time. I need to start the processing. So in fact, I was hot. I have to rely on friends to connect me to the government, the passport office in Ghana. So I paid huge amounts. But, you know, when you want it fast, you need to add so you can have it fast. So fortunately, I had my passport, gave it out to the management. They started the process, and I was part of the 20 delegates from Ghana who came to the Philippines. That was when I met you, me at the office, and thank you and your friends. I love the reservation. It was great. And we're happy in Philippines. We're very happy in Philippines. So this is what I want to say. We have extrinsic motivation and intrinsic motivation. Extrinsic motivation is whereby people are motivated by people having their cars, houses, machines, and other, you know, materials. Should I say materials? That is what motivates a lot of people. And it's propelled them to also work harder, all right? Because they know that, yes, when I work hard, like Annie, who is everywhere, working hard every now and then, I can also achieve, you know, that goal. I can also get there. I can also buy my car. I can also buy my land and start building. No, buy something for myself. Yeah, those ones are stressing. It is good motivation. But the question is, do those ones also last forever? So looking at it, extrinsic definitely will come when you look at the intrinsic. That is, why are you joining the business? You should know your why. You shouldn't look at, how do you call it, the extrinsic, the cars, you know, the houses, and then the properties other people are making. But you should be interested in helping other people as well. So just as my great leader, Mr. Inkum, rightly said, we got connected, and he's really doing well, really, really doing well. So he said something that is helping others. And in fact, he's not leaving any stone unturned. Exactly how I started, right? So the idea was to help other people also live the best of their lives, all right? And I think the dream is being, you know, being achieved, because one or two or three people I'm still mentoring them. They are happy now. Some are breadwinners and things weren't going well for them. But then after seeing the opportunity and seeing how viable it is, I introduced them to AIM Global. Initially, they were reluctant, but they accepted my invite. They came to the office to see the bigger picture, and they joined. And God being so good, these guys are doing well for themselves and then their family. I'm happy seeing them always. You know, that alone motivates me, solving human problem. Or let's say somebody is suffering from health issues, AIM Global is there to help. So it's like I am using the opportunity AIM Global have to help other people. That is exactly what everybody is doing. That is exactly what everybody is doing. So I am happy. One guy who was from Kumasi, another city in the second city in Ghana, came to Accra, the main city in Ghana. After his schooling, his university education and all that, he came looking for a job. Along the line, things weren't going on well for him. So he decided to quit and go back to Kumasi where he came from. I advised him that, no, guy, we can do this. I've seen this opportunity. Why don't you join me and let's start building a team? He agreed. So gradually, I taught him the do's and the don'ts because I had much an experience than him. AIM Global is his first network marketing he's joining. And you know what? The good news is he got married just 2 months ago. He had his apartment, you know, had everything he should have. And now this guy is really enjoying. And a lot of guys, young guys I am mentoring. So I am happy seeing them. Okay, that is my joy, to see somebody being happy. But not to have the car and then the houses. It is good. I'm not saying that shouldn't be the motivation. But if you should have people at heart and you want to help them to grow, those who are coachable, those who think, yes, I can do this, why not? You help them. And definitely when you do, you will also...
One day I'll be here. iPhone 11. Oh.
Can you hear me? Hello? Honey?
Yes, ma'am. Loud and clear.
It's loud and clear, very well.
You can hear me.
All right. Okay. So just as I was saying, if you have people at heart, and then you give them all what they need to be successful, and these guys are coachable, they are humble to listen to you, they are ready to work with you hand in hand, I tell you, success definitely will be theirs. And look at AIM Global's system. If you have one account, one on the left, one on the right, help them to be successful. And if you should do that, they are happy. And when they are happy, automatically you become rich, or you are also happy, all right? But then a lot of people quit the business just because they've seen that, yes, Annie has a car, Annie have done that, I've tipped that. So I am also going to use, let's say, 6 months, or 1 year to get there. It is good to give yourself targets. It is very good to give yourself targets. But what happens when the 1 year approaches, or yes, 1 year has expired, and yes, still you've not been able to buy your car. You've not been able to achieve what you plan of achieving, all right? Your goals and ambitions, a stressful one. What happens? It is easy for you to quit the business. But within you, if you know that my goal is to make people, other people happy, all right? Definitely, you will be happy and nothing will stop you from quitting. Nothing will stop you from going on doing the business. So what I will say is AIM Global is a God-sent business. AIM Global is what I do full-time to take care of my beautiful family. And I'm using this to also help a lot of people out there. And we are achieving. I've not gotten to where I've gotten to. I am still working hard. I'm still, you know, pushing forward. And I know definitely Sky will be the starting point. So with the team I am working with who are self-motivated, I am telling you, they are really working hard with me. So one thing is this, guys, if you want to be successful, you need to be self-motivated. If not, along the line, when things are not happening, you quit. You need to be self-motivated. Yes, it is very, very important. Self-motivated. Come again.
Also,
you need to be self-motivated. Yes, you should know why you are involved in this. Okay, nobody should tell you to do this before you do. All right, you need to push harder. You need to know, yes, this is why I am doing that. Okay, give yourself target. Just as I said, it is good to give yourself target. Okay, but don't rely on when it hit your, let's say you get there and nothing happens, so you need to quit. No, that shouldn't be the main reason why you should be doing this. All right. Yes, you joined AIM Global because you've seen that, yes, it's a business that you can get involved and use that opportunity to help a lot of people. So my dear leaders, I hope we have our African brothers here, our Ghanaian brothers, our Nigerian brothers here. All what I want to tell you is this. This is God sent. And in Africa, network marketing is not known. Yes, a lot of people have been involved and all that. But statistics shows that it is just 1% of the entire Africa who knows about network marketing. So we are pushing the industry so hard. A lot of network marketing have come, some are scammers, we all know. And then there's been a lot of misconception about it. I know that this is the best in that. I'm also pushing so hard, okay, to get the good message across for people to know that, yes, we have something good. For even the government to know that network marketing is an industry that the government can also consider and let a lot of people know about it. We are trying hard, you know. So it's like, guys, those, especially those who have started, you need to learn. You need to do your research. You need to be mentored. Probably you are working with one of the big companies in your country, whether it's in Ghana or any other country. But the thing is this, you are an industry that you can, you know, use the opportunity to help a lot of people and become rich. Build your house, buy cars, travel across the globe, your accounts, your bank account to be good. Yes. But the thing is this, you have to empty yourself. Emptying yourself means whatever you know in your area of specifications, please don't. There should be a difference. If you draw a thin line between that and this, this industry is different. So empty that and then be humble, be coachable. So your mentors will inform and teach you what you need to do. All right. By doing that, you see, you'll be excelling and success definitely will be yours. Network marketing, the thing is, if you should learn, if you are humble and if you work hard, success definitely will be yours. I am telling you. Irrespective of the time it will take, success will come, whether you like it or not. Our parents have to work 40 years and more, but not to disgrace them, they have nothing to show, all right? They have nothing to show. But network marketing is telling you that if you should work it hard, if you should work at it, okay, if you should be humble and be coachable and learn, definitely, definitely, success will come. And the good part, and what I love most, is you are using the right opportunity to help other people as well. So we can go on and on and on. Let's look at the bigger picture, and the concept is let's help, especially my brothers in Africa. let's use this opportunity, the industry, the network marketing industry, to help a lot of people, to educate them, for them to know that, yes, there is an industry that can change the economy of our country. Danny.
Yes, there.
I want to pause here. If there's any questions or something, add up or anything.
Bender, I'm sorry, I didn't hear you clearly. Yellow.
Hello, Annie, can you hear me?
Yes, mentor, loud and clear.
Very well. Very well. So this is a little of what I have to say. So I don't know if you have questions for me or any other something you want me to explain. You are welcome.
All right. Okay, mentor. Philip, thank you very much for that very inspiring, very nice sharing with our team. And, thank you. Very big thank you, even though we're still deep, but you still make to share with us. And let me just ask some of our partners, maybe they like to ask something about you. Okay guys, if you have suggestions, feel free to ask. If you have a questions, you guys have a question? Yeah. Okay, I think they don't have a question here. Mentor Frank, maybe you would like to ask. Mentor Jonathan, do you have any questions? Or Mentor Daniel, feel free to ask. Oh, is this Michael Esa is with you, Mentor?
Hello.
Hello, Michael Esa Kabanto. Good morning. Is he with you? I think it's you because the name is just like the owner of our Pani Kabantog. Okay. Someone wants to ask. Hello iPhone. Who is this iPhone? iPhone. Oh, you're learning so much. Hello. Okay. Oh, give me a second.